We noticed the smell maybe like last Wednesday. So, yeah, it's been a smell, but we thought it was garbage.
A decaying body found in a Fort Myers neighborhood. Lincoln Boulevard was closed for much of this morning after Fort Myers police made a grim discovery at an abandoned house. NBC2's Alex Howard joins us live from where police discovered the body. Here in the studio, that neighbors could smell just for days, Alex.
Neighbors say the house has been vacant for a month, and right in the backyard, you can see the outline of the body that was found there. And I can assure you, the smell was just terrible. A chilling discovery.
We didn't know what it was. We thought it was just a smell. We didn't know it was a body. We thought it was like an animal or something. So, yeah, I'm surprised.
At first, neighbors thought it was just another dead animal or garbage left outside.
We noticed the smell maybe like last Wednesday. So, yeah, it's been a smell, but we thought it was garbage.
But as the days went by and the smell got worse, neighbors started to notice.
We never seen a body being found, but we've seen a lot of shootings and all of that, you know, but as far as in a body, no.
Until police found the gruesome scene, a body laying on the ground. Some who live in the neighborhood want to know why it took so long.
You don't talk, because if you talk, there might be retaliation on you. So even though you see a body there, laying there dead, you don't want to say nothing.
After removing the body and documenting the scene, Fort Myers crime scene detectives reopened Lincoln Boulevard before noon, leaving only the distinctive outline of a body behind.
It had to have been there 2 or 3 days. The buzzards ate his eyes out, picking on his body. They had to smell it.
Now, we've reached out to the Fort Myers Police Department for more information on this investigation and whether or not this is a homicide, but right now, we haven't yet heard back. Count on NBC2 to bring you the latest both on air and online. Live in the studio, Alex Howard, NBC2.